All right, I'm going to show you how I IR hop my guns. This is primarily focused at Daytona guns. I know there's other videos on YouTube and how they do it. This is how I do it. I get it. There might be some better ways. I've done it this way so many times. In general, I am just stuck on this way and it works for me. And I'll show you some reasons why I'm more focused at the Daytona group right now. And let me just get some of this stuff out of the way. I'm going to be using all that you just saw pictured, by the way. Added to that is also going to be a Dremel and a barrel. All right, so first and foremost, the tubing. All right, so nothing against silicone tubing, like so. That's what most people have been using. I get it. There's silicone tubing and the EPDM rubber. It's a little soft, and that's not bad. The problem with that is on a Daytona gun is, due to it being soft, the nub that Daytonas use is a screw, is actually a set screw. The top dead center style comes down and pushes on it. And the problem with it being soft is it ends up deforming it and kind of getting rid of the curvature that you have, and sometimes basically just making it into a flat hop, essentially. It's also does not like lube nearly as much as this rubber right here does. And I'm not saying it likes lube or dislikes it, I mean, all the way. The silicone, if you get a little more lube on it, it's a little less forgiving and it will cause it not to hop as much. With this durable Tygon rubber that Tony recommends, it's not, you know, it's not immune to lube. If you get tons of lube on it too, it will also, you know, not hop your BB, but it's a little more susceptible to getting wet and not, and still continuing to hop. So what I end up doing is, first I take the tubing and I look at my barrel, what I got. I already know what I'm gonna end up using for this. I'm using a Prime ABC Bright 6.05 barrel. I have, in my little tin here, three different drill bits. You can use whatever you want to. I already know for those barrels, it seems to be this drill bit right here works. All three are slightly different diameters, very close together though. I do the same thing for my AEG setup. Different size drill bits for that tubing though. And what I do with it is, I try to get it to match the barrel as close as I possibly can. Therefore, I don't have to sand the inside of the barrel. So I'm gonna show you a size that I know is not gonna work for this barrel, just to, I mean, give you something to maybe hopefully look at here. So what I first do is I take this drill bit, I slide it in as far as I can where I have no flutes exposed. I grab a razor blade. Mine might be a little dull here, so hopefully it cups this pretty smoothly. I find the back where the drill bit is, kind of just grab it with my finger, just gently. As long as your razor blade's sharp, it should cut no problem. Kind of just get started, and just I take the razor blade and I push down on it and give it a little angle so I can try to maintain contact with the razor blade and the drill bit. Excuse me, to make my patch hopefully one fluid, one straight cut basically, so I don't have an uneven waviness to the patch. So again, get it started and just go. See, my razor blade is kind of dull. Then take it, give it a little wobbly wobbly. I'm even cutting it, went a little bit behind it, wobbly wobbly, and pull the patch off. It'll look like that, and then you'll have your patch in your hand here. Put that off to the side for the moment. I usually quickly look at it, and this is gonna be a prime example of what it should not look like, actually, from what I quickly could see with my eye. You can see the patch is definitely uneven. It's not straight. And that's just from me giving a jagged cut. The sharper your razor blade, the better. So don't do that. Or if you do that, you're gonna restart. So I'm gonna do another one here. Ah, like butter, much better cut. Put that to the side. Closely looking at this one, much better. Now some of you people might be saying, oh man, this ID and the OD is just wrong. It is durable Tygon rubber. It is 3/16 ID, 5/16 OD, 1/16 wall. That is what it is. It is not the silicone 6mm ID and 8 OD or 9 OD. It will maintain this curvature and this shape though. At least it does for me. So I'm just gonna give you an example. The patch I'm gonna end up using, the BB, hopefully you can see it, still is getting grabbed nicely. Not just barely touching the top, it's still gonna engage the BB nicely. Mm. All right, so back to the patch that I cut. So after I get it, you can rig up jigs. I've made little weird things that I use to help try to cut it straight. Other than that, after a while, like I can already see that's kind of cut at an angle, just try to straighten it out. Did a bad job putting that close to the camera. All right, got a little straighter. Some people like to take the barrel next. Kind of see how long they got to cut it. I just kind of go by now. I've got so much tubing, I don't even, waste is not really a concern of mine. The tubing's cheap. Then you're gonna find just a rough length that you wanna cut it. Make it as straight as possible and cut it off. So there's a little piece. All right, so next, what you'll need to do is take the barrel and just kind of laying it on top of it. Now here's the thing, I probably won't be able to show you on camera, but what you're gonna do is take this, just gently push the tubing, don't push the center of it down, just grab the feet of it, the edges, and just kind of hold it and secure it on the barrel. Look, point the barrel up at your face, this end up, look inside and see how close the inner diameter, the actual inside radius of the patch matches the inside radius of the barrel. The idea is to get it pretty much as close as you can. I get it. The inside diameter of the tubing is not the exact inside diameter of the barrel. Fully understand that. But still look and see how close you can get. For instance, I can see a pretty big gap on this. I'll try to take a picture and show you afterwards, but probably won't be able to see it. But that's the idea of it. Now, if for some reason you're like, oh man, the gap of it is a lot, that's fine. Take your drill bit that you used, for instance, if the gap is a lot, you would use a smaller drill bit, or sorry, you would use a larger drill bit, so that way when you're cutting the tubing, if you used a larger drill bit, as you're cutting it, for instance, this one's a little bit tighter inside there, it's obviously gonna shrink down the overall length, the whole size of the patch itself. So I've already done that. This is the drill bit that I ended up using, and I got this patch. So now when I take this patch and I put it on top of the barrel and I do it as I just described to you and you look inside, when you look inside, it's gonna end up being pretty dang close to the inside. Not exact. To be fair, the legs and the actual radius is just riding off, if I can pull the patch out, it's just riding off the insides of the window here, which is fine. So when I push down, when the engagement of the screw pushes this down, the legs here, or the inside diameter, just pretty much just that actual radius, is gonna push right through the window, and that's it. I will show you a picture of what it's gonna look like, you know, with the hop engaged afterwards. So next, what I end up doing is I take this little snazzy tool that I bought from Shapeways a long time ago. Hunter Seeker makes it, to stick inside the barrel. You can really use anything that's basically a 6mm ID, something that's close, something that basically is not going to allow any RTV or glue or whatever so you're using. I use glue to get A, inside the barrel, and B, what it's gonna do is, let's just say for some reason, well, I mean, I am not a machine, I'm not a laser cutter. I will say by the eye, that's pretty close to looking straight. If your patch is a little short in length, this inside rod will also help maybe touch the radius depending on how deep your patch is. It'll keep it outside of the window basically. So I then will, I'll leave that rod in there and I will push the patch on top. And before I do anything really, I'm gonna give a quick look here. I'm gonna look at the sides right here and see that, okay, cool, the patch is in fact touching. It's touching the barrel, awesome. Other side, it's touching the barrel, there's no gap. That's a big plus, and I have this rod inside there. So therefore I know, in theory, then when I pull this rod out, a BB is going to drop right through the barrel, so I don't have to sand the inside, so the inside radius of the patch is not protruding into the barrel, and I will be able to glue these legs down because they are touching. Awesome. Now, I don't know if you can see, but the barrel, or the patch, is sticking up a little higher than the outside diameter of the barrel. Not much of a problem, we'll get to that later. So, to me, I'm ready to glue the patch. So I'll put the barrel aside real quick. I'm gonna take some sandpaper. You could use, this is 600, you could use a little thicker if you want. And I really don't do much. I kind of just give it, I'll flip the patch the other direction just to, and that's it, to be honest. I don't really get over crazy with it. It is now just lightly roughed. I will grab this little tool here. Also comes like in a kit to do R-hops from Hunter Seeker. You can use whatever you want. I'm going to lay it inside there. I'm going to grab the drill bit that I used. I'm going to take this 600 You can use a little coarser if you'd like. This is just what I end up using all the time, and it seems to work for me. It's going to look like so. You lay that there. I'm going to hold this with my finger, and I'm going to just ever so gently just do a couple of strokes. Not a lot. It just doesn't really take as much as some people make it out to be. And all I'm doing is just kind of putting a slight little radius in the front to help prevent any pinch jams if it's going to happen or not. Pinch jam is basically when you engage the R-hop patch, just due to a solid lip in the front, the BB sometimes just boop, hits it and doesn't go anywhere. All right, keep it oriented so I know which way that was. Put this rod back in there. Some people like to prep the outer surface of the barrels too. You can, it's a brand new barrel. I haven't had any problems doing that. If you want to, maybe take some of that sandpaper and just do a quick, light little scuff on the actual barrel window. Be sure to clean the barrel out afterwards. I use Loctite super glue. You could use all kinds of different types of super glue. One of the main things is it does contain CA in it, so it does dry pretty quickly, which is a plus and a con. I like this one specifically because it's kind of like a gel type, so it doesn't dry as fast, and it's a little more, I can play with it a little bit more. I can move it around. I use a toothpick. I don't just go globbing shit all over this thing and hope for the best. So, I put just a little bit there on the end. This is going to be pretty hard to do in front of the camera, so I apologize if it goes in and out of frame a little bit. That's actually a lot of glue. If you see how much I have on there, that's a lot. I will get rid of some of that. All right. See that little dab that is put on there? I'm going to gently put a real light thin layer on there. Then I'm going to put some more glue on it. Going to do the other side. Gotta give it a little look. I feel like I could use a little bit more on the other side. There you go, put the toothpick away. I am now going to take the patch. Woo! Push it up inside there, grab the secondary tool, and because it does stick up a little bit from the inside diameter, I'm going to just push real nicely so I know I can, I'm going to push the patch on there. Give that a go for a minute. Just kind of letting it dry. Like I said, the glue doesn't dry nearly as fast. It's just regular old CA glue. Just going to give it some pressure, let it do its thing. Maybe I'll take this rod now and just kind of pull it a little bit, make sure there's no glue stuck on it. It came out same strength that it was before. I know I didn't get any glue on the inside. Now, I'm going to take this off. You can see, it's a nicely glued patch on there, but again, it still sticks up. Sticks up, not a lot, to be honest, just a little bit above it. So we're going to have to obviously sand that down. Here's where I differ, I think, than some things, maybe not. Someone else there probably does it, I don't know. I'm gonna take some glue here. I know that I can see that the actual legs are making contact. The back is touching, the front is touching. If you are gonna cut the patch a little short and you're gonna leave a little gap, make sure you leave the gap in the front of the barrel, or the front of the actual barrel window. I'm gonna put a little drop of glue right there. I say a little, it's a little bit bigger than a little. I'm gonna take my toothpick. I'm gonna touch the patch with it. Essentially kind of glue in the side of the patch to the barrel. You might be like, what in the hell is he doing? That's crazy, disgusting. It's never gonna seal. Absolutely correct. I'm not gonna leave it like that. I've had way too many times where I go to sand this patch down to the outside diameter and this damn thing goes flying across my room. And I say flying because I use a Dremel, and I'll show you that. You can also use sandpaper, which is what a lot of people use and a lot of people recommended. I don't know. I just haven't had any luck with sandpaper. I'm going to go over it with sandpaper at the end. But my initial sandpaper, I've still ripped the damn patch out. And it just takes too long. I'm impatient. So now I'm going to let that sit there for a couple minutes. And when we come back, I will show you the next part. All right. Take a toothpick, you know, touch it a little bit, see if it's dry. Cool, it seems pretty dry. Good to go to the next step. All right, I leave whatever the rod is that I'm using on the inside, mainly so that way whenever I'm sanding it down, if the patch wants to engage a little bit, it's gonna just be pressed on that. There's actually a hard backing to it. I use a Dremel and a barrel sander wheel. Now, I don't know if it'll show through, but if you can see it, this barrel sander, I mean, it's rough, don't get me wrong, but it is not new. It's been used heavily. The reason for that is if I used a brand new one, it kind of cuts a little rougher, a little more aggressive. So this nicely used one takes off a smaller amount at a time, and it allows me just to get a nicer finish on it. So there's probably a bunch of different ways you can do this. Again, this is the way that I do it. Kind of just hold it here. This is gonna be pretty hard, I think, in front of the camera, so I'll try my best. I'm going to take this and I'm going to basically just do a rocking motion with it. Try to keep the barrel as even as I can and just touch the patch. If you do touch the barrel a little bit, it's not the end of the world. Your little pretty brass barrel is not going to hate your life or perform any worse for it. My Dremel is also adjustable, so I go to slow speed. That's low for mine. Half high. Don't like to do high, I go on low. Low is fine. Take it. Again, I'm gonna try my best on the camera. You like to get on top of it, but we'll see. One pass. Nice slow, try to make it even. I'm gonna turn the Dremel off for a second. And kind of wipe away the barrel a little bit. Give it a little look to see how much is actually coming off. It is coming off evenly. Probably be able to see it, but I'm gonna keep going. Take too much, then yes, eventually you will end up cutting into your pretty little barrel. Maybe see some black flaking. I don't know if you can or not. It's just the tubing. Give it another look. Very close. It's very close to being smooth. That tool that I also bought with that kit, you can kind of do like a little, it's gonna be kind of hard because there's glue a little bit on it, which we will scrape off, but it already's coming over it. I'm gonna do it a little bit more. You can kind of see, oh no, I touched my barrel. Be all right. All right. It's getting pretty smooth there. Now, if you're like, hey, I think I'm at a pretty good stopping spot, so eventually I will go back over it with some sandpaper. Some like to rub front to back. Some like to go back and forth on it. So give me a second. I'm just going to fast forward this a little bit, and we'll get to the good part. Gonna go after it with a little bit of some 600 grit this way. Yep, I got the barrel a little bit. I'm not that upset about it. Now there's still some glue here. on the sides. So I just take this little snazzy guy. I just, you can use whatever you want. Just scrape it away. You can see there, I did in fact scrape it slightly with the Dremel. It's a little bit more difficult doing it like this in front of the camera. You could use whatever you want to scrape it off, but using the razor blade that I got with me. Yes, the patch is a little discolored. It's from the brass from sandpaper. So if you want, just clean it off with something. I got some, stole my wife's acetone. Kind of confiscated the bottle. Just do a little dab there on the patch. Clean if the brass is killing you. There you go. I'm gonna take this out now. So, is anything on the inside? Just maybe blow it out. Run a cleaning rod through it. Take a drill bit here. Might be kinda hard to see, but I'm gonna stand it up here. Take a toothpick. Lightly touch it. It should just fall right through. Show you from the other direction. It's getting stuck right at the very end of the barrel. It's mainly just from the barely it didn't have to blow. It's just from there's a little bit of debris in there that I need to clean out with the cleaning rod. Other than that, it's basically all there is to it. Again, if you want to, you can look if there's any more glue. Get the rest of it off. I don't really see much more. It'll be all right. If you don't want to nick up, you don't want to sand the barrel like this, you can go side to side, just keep it a little more even. But nonetheless, that is it in a nutshell. I'll show you a picture real quick of what it looks like engaged into a Daytona Gun hop-up unit. The last thing I will say that I might do different, I do happen to use this screw, this set screw as far as engagement, and hopefully you can see it in the picture or the video there. It is actually flat as opposed to a normal set screw. I just feel it gives a little bit slightly different, a little more of a flatter push. But again, I'll show you a picture. If you have any questions, I guess put it in the comments below. Other than that, hopefully you all figured that out. There was no sanding on the inside, a little bit on the outside. And the picture will show that it still maintains its curvature and hops BBs just fine. So all right, other than that, have a good day.